As another day in Dillydale comes to a close, night falls. And with night comes the dark. Of course, with the dark comes the light. So the Mr. Men and Little Misses have no reason to fear the dark. Unless, of course, they fear everything anyway.
I sure do appreciate you coming over to change my light bulb, Mr. Boom.
Oh, it's terrible to be in the dark, Miss Helpful. Where's the lamp?
Oh, it's not a lamp. It's the light over the stairs. Didn't I mention that?
I don't think you did, Miss Helpful.
It's that bulb right there.
Uh-huh. What exactly is down these stairs?
Oh, just the basement. You know, cobwebs, big scary spiders, maybe an old rake and a rusty shovel. Now, about that light bulb, you think you can reach it?
Yeah, I'll give it a try.
Hey, maybe if you stand on the handrail. I'll hold you.
Well, okay. Now hold on to me so I don't fall.
Will do. You know, I bet this would be easier with a ladder.
Found your rake.
Here's the new light bulb.
Okay.
Oh, wait. That's not the new light bulb. That's the one that's burned out. I'll go get a new one.
No, don't. Nobody move.
Mr. Boom, I'll be right back with a light bulb that works.
Okay, that should do it. Flip the switch, Miss Helpful. Let there be light.
What was that, Mr. Boom? To the right? More height?
No, I said light. Light! No!
No problem, Mr. Boom.
Giant spider!
Thank you, Mr. Bump. Mr. Bump. Hey, what's this switch go to? I forgot all about this other light. I guess I don't need that light bulb changed after all.
Good to know, Miss Helpful. Back! Back, I say! Shoo! Shoo!
Looks like someone needs to dance. Come on, everybody, let's dance. Dance, dance, dance. Everybody dance, dance, dance.
Oh, isn't this nice? I've always wanted to visit the famous giant pine tree forest, and here I am. Oh, they certainly are tall trees that block out the moonlight, making it very dark. I know I have a... who's there? Silly. That tree branch wasn't tapping me on the shoulder. I definitely felt something that time. Oh, no. No. I'm surrounded. There's no way out.
Mr. Nosy! Good tidings. Mr. Nosy and I just wanted to welcome you to Tiny Pines Vacation Cabins.
Mm-hmm. We gave you the cabin with the best view of the Tiny Pines Forest.
If there's anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable, don't hesitate to ask.
Vacation's over! Giant, horrendous, menacing trees! I can't believe he's not going to stay for the free breakfast pastries.
Some people are a mystery, Nose. Some people are a mystery.
Shazam! This is gonna be good and scary.
It certainly is, Mr. Messy. That's why I invited you over. I much prefer company when frightened. Popcorn?
Don't mind if I do, Mr. Pissnickety.
Welcome to Miss Scary's Late Night Scare Fest. I'll be showing you some classic scares with the help of my assistant, Mr. Bounce. Mr. Bounce!
I bet he
wearing my scary masks without my permission. Mr. Bounce!
You rang, Miss Scary?
That was fantastic, Mr. Bounce! But I do the scaring around here. Let's not forget it's called Miss Scary's Late Night Scarefest, not Mr. Bounce's Late Night Scarefest. Watch!
That is one frightening little miss.
I'll say, do you have more butter for this popcorn?
Shh. I'm trying to listen.
All of Dillydale knows that you are the queen of fright, Miss Scary. Your masks are ready.
Excellent, Mr. Bounce. Bring them to me. Mr. Bounce, stop playing around.
Now that's scary.
It certainly is. Mr. Messy, do not wipe your filthy hands on my clean sofa.
I don't like the looks of this.
Neither do I. I see butter stains.
You're ruining my show.
I am sorry, Miss Scary. Goodbye.
Don't forget to bring back my mask. Glad that's over. Now it's time for some real scares. Come closer!
Mr. Messy!
Sorry, Mr. B, but I get extra messy when I'm scared.
Then change the channel, quickly.
I can't find the remote!
This is the last time I invite you over to watch television. No!
Shuffle step, tap, tap, change feet, tap, tap. There you go, tap, tap. Everybody shuffle.
If it's okay with you, Mr. P, I'm going home.
Yes, please do. Good night.
Guess there was nothing to be afraid of. It's only TV.
Boing, boing, boing.
Mr. Persnickety, let me back in.
It's somewhere in that swamp, gentlemen. The legendary Dillydale Swamp Creature.
This is a waste of time, Mr. Grumpy. The swamp creature does not exist.
I'll tell that to my boat. That monster bit off my propeller last night.
Your boat is cheap. The propeller probably fell off.
I told you the monster's in here, and it only comes out at night. Now, are you going to help me catch that thing or what?
I'm going to prove you wrong.
This is a bad idea.
Mr. Quiet, start tossing that monster bait into the water.
Oh, gross.
You think this swamp creature is going to come out for fish guts?
Yes. Now, if you hear a gurgling sound, it means the monster is near. So be ready to shine your light on it.
Oh, that's an awful lot of people.
Best not to talk, Mr. Quiet. The swamp creature won't come out if there's noise.
It won't come out because it does not exist. This story is made up to keep people out of the swamp at night.
I'm telling you, I saw the thing with my own eyes, right here from my fishing boat.
Are you sure you didn't see a frog?
Yes.
Or a turtle?
No, it was not a turtle.
Over here.
Or was it a duck?
No, it was not a duck. It was a swamp creature. A scary, giant swamp creature. Will you stop it?
I'll stop when you stop telling stories.
I should have known better than to invite you on this expedition.
And I should have known better than to accept.
You might want to turn around.
Don't interrupt, Mr. Quiet. Mr. Grumpy and I are having a discussion.
More like a person who's completely right talking to one who's completely wrong.
I'm glad you finally see things my way, Mr. Grumpy.
Oh, croak, cucumbers.
No,
Mr. Sandman.
Oh, where'd he go off to? He ran off? Well, let's go home. All this hooting and hollering must have scared the monster away.
Mr. Stubborn! It's a swamp creature!
I told you this swamp creature does not exist!
Well, then what is that?
This? This is just a big frog!
All across Dillydale, there are those who embrace the darkness, while others wish to avoid it. And then, there are those who truly know how to celebrate the dark.